We're going to be making the simple level by leveraging Lua scripting to populate the game pieces, AI nav mesh to move the agent around, and writing a few classes to help us load the scene. It may look simple, but it's always easy to add more complexity when we're finished. Let's get started. We'll be using the Moonsharp package available for Unity to run our Lua scripts. Now we can jump back into Unity, go ahead and install it. Lua is a lightweight scripting language named after the moon in Portuguese, hence the package name Moonsharp. This simple language only has 21 reserved keywords and just one data structure called a table. Being so small and easy to use makes this an ideal language as to build up our modding framework with. Now that Moonsharp is installed, let's continue on. In the scene, create a ground plane. I'll resize mine a bit just to have a little bit of room to play with. Let's add a physics layer named Walkable and assign this to our ground plane. This will help later with our nav mesh. Now we'll make a simple character with a capsule, and we're going to make this an AI agent who does our playtesting for us. We'll add the nav mesh agent component and a rigid body component to our agent. Set the rigid body to isKinematic, as the nav mesh agent will be driving around our character. Next, make a blank object in our hierarchy and name this nav mesh. Add a nav mesh surface component and go ahead and hit bake. That should make a bluish surface over our plane, and then we know it's working. Let's go back to our agent and add a simple script. I'm naming mine Agent Navigation. Let's jump in and make sure that our agent can go to the coordinates 000 on start. Let's test this out and make sure we have everything working up to this point. Let's move our agent somewhere else, hit play, and our agent should try to go to the center. We know it's working. Great. We'll make this a little bit more interesting by making a few goals for our agent to try to get to. Create a new script and call it hover settings. Scriptable objects are a great way to save settings and other functionality that might be common among multiple objects. Now that our hover settings are done, we can make the object in the project hierarchy. I put mine in the scriptable objects folder. Let's make a floating block that our agent will try to collect. First, we'll make an empty object and add a cube as a child. This will help the hover movement that we're going to add next stay localized while the parent can move around. Add the simple hover script to the cube. And just remember, the source code is linked in the description below. This class uses the functions in the scriptable object to do the hover behavior. Drag the hover settings onto the hover component. I'm adding a material just to make it look better. Let's finish our goal by adding a goal tag. We'll also add a box collider and check the box is trigger. That should finish this goal, so I'm going to drag this into my prefabs folder. Now we need to get our agent to change from always going to the center of the map to going to our goals. Let's define this behavior by modifying the agent navigation script. For the agent, I want it to collect the items into a backpack as it goes along. I'll create an empty child object on the agent, name it backpack, and place it just behind the agent along the z-axis. In our agent navigator class, we need to keep track of the collected objects. Our agent might collect more than one goal along the way to its new destination. If we keep track of all collected goals, then remove them before selecting the new goal, then we'll always be sure that we're only going after uncollected goals. When the agent is triggered by interacting with the collider on the goal, we'll add that goal to our backpack. If the goal was our final destination, we'll update the agent to move to a next random goal. Let's jump back into the editor and set up the component references for our agent. We'll update the component reference for our backpack, and we'll go ahead and set the string to be goal. That's the tag that we're looking for. And our agent happily moves around. That's great. So far, so good. Let's keep going. Let's start with the game manager. Create a new object in the game hierarchy. Call it game manager. We'll go ahead and add a script component as well. And we'll call that game manager too. Inside the script, we're going to define two event actions. One for on level loaded and one for on game start. This is going to use a simple singleton pattern. We won't go into the evils of singletons, but they work great for small demos like this. Let's create another new object in the hierarchy. We'll name this script runner and we'll go ahead and add a script to it. We'll call that script runner too. This script runner is going to contain a few things that we're going to need globally. So we'll make this a singleton as well. We're going to make a script type here. This is where Moonsharp's interpreter starts. In the awake function, let's register a few global things, like print. We want to define the print function in Lua to output using the Unity terminal, otherwise we're not going to see anything. In the start function, let's have the script run a string, and we'll just write print hello from Lua. Let's run our program real quick, and we should see hello from Lua in the console. Cool. Let's set up a few other common things we're going to need. We'll register Vector3 and Quaternion, and we'll define those functions in the script. These definitions allow us to bridge what happens in C# and Lua. Lua is now aware of a Vector3 and a Quaternion function existing, and there's a map to the C# function that'll get called when we use those functions in Lua. Let's create a second script called initializeLevel. Let's specify the name of the Lua file that we want to load, and we'll go ahead and create a function to load the script contents. Let's use our own scriptrunner class to make sure we get access to globals, like the print we set up. Let's go create the Lua file. Unity doesn't normally support creating Lua files with a context menu, so let's make an editor script that will do that for us. We'll create an editor script called create Lua file in the editor folder. This gets the folder open in the project view and creates a new Lua file. It then sets the file as the active selection. Now that we have that, let's go ahead and generate a Lua script. Let's create a folder called Streaming Assets and place a new script in there. We'll right-click and notice now we have a new context menu called Lua Scripts. I'm going to name mine Level 0. Double-click to open it. You might be prompted to determine how to open the Lua script on your computer. Any text editor will work. I'm using Visual Studio Code. It already has a print function in there. We defined that in the editor script. Let's make sure the initialize level script component is set up with the right file name, and we'll try running this. And there's our print. Perfect. Let's make one more scriptable object that contains all the level pieces that we're going to want to spawn. I'm naming mine level pieces. This will have a list we can populate in the inspector and a dictionary we can use in the script later. Let's create our scriptable object right next to our hover settings, and I'll go ahead and add the cube that we made earlier for our goal. Let's go to our initialize level script and add a few more functions. Let's make one to set up Lua variables, and another to spawn level pieces. Let's call this from the start function. We're also going to do something new with the game manager. We're going to tell it that we've loaded the level. Now that we've got everything set up to run the Lua script, and map it to C# functions, let's go ahead and spawn some pieces from the script. In my Lua script, I've written a few functions to create a circle of goals. I'm using a for loop here to go from degrees 30 to 360 inclusively by increments of 30 degrees. I use the math library to access sine and cosine functions. I use the spawn level piece, Vector3, and quaternion Euler functions that we defined in C#. If we run this, we'll get a perfect circle of goals for our AI agent to run around and collect. Let's update the agent navigation script to find the goals only after the game manager says the game has started. We'll use the onGameStart event that we created in the game manager to do this. And we'll unsubscribe from the event when the object is destroyed, just in case. Now our agent should happily find all the goals and navigate to each one. I'm going to make my level a little bit more interesting by creating a stage and some stairs. I'll create the stage and stairs using ProBuilder. You can install ProBuilder through the package manager under the Unity registry. ProBuilder will let us make a few quick assets like stages and stairs. You can also use it to make walls, add textures to things, mess with the UV maps. It's cool for prototyping. I'm going to use the physics layer, Walkable, that we created earlier so that the nav mesh can find these later. I'll make prefabs out of these just like we did the cube earlier. We'll update our nav mesh surface component to only include layers that are walkable. Make sure the ground, the stairs, and the platform are all marked with the physics layer, Walkable. Let's add a new script to our nav mesh. This will subscribe to the onLevelLoaded event from the game manager. When we get this event, we'll go ahead and rebuild the nav mesh. That'll include the new platforms and stairs that we're going to set up in the Lua script. I played around trying to make this look okay with the stairs that I set up, and this is my final script. We need to add our stairs and our platform to the scriptable object for the level pieces for this to spawn. Let's hit play and watch the agent go collect things on top of the platforms as well as the circle. I would love to see where you guys can take this. I hope you guys had as much fun as I did. Thanks for watching. As a final touch, I'm going to change my character to be this cool little robot that I built in Blender. Check in the description below for the source code. Thanks for watching.